am Dr. Betters. Welcome to Ask Dr. Betters. One of the things that I see happening all around us is there's a change in the culture. There's a change in the generational cultures, for example, between my age group and the millennials. You know, you take a look at what people are doing and the decisions that they're making, it can become very troublesome if you're not focused on what the scriptures teach. One of the things that I've noticed in the almost 50 years of pastoral ministry is the way in which people making their way to the church, sitting in the pews of the church, but they're living together without the benefit of marriage. They choose not to get married. They choose to keep their own last names and not find any sort of way in which to address the question of what the scripture says about marriage and the purpose of marriage. And so I have a question like this one. I came to know Christ as my Savior in my 20s and am getting ready to get married. We both have successful careers and I'm not sure I want to change my last name. Is there anything wrong with keeping your maiden name? I really want to honor and respect my husband as the Bible calls me to, but in today's day and age, the last name thing just seems like a tradition that is fading. Well, it might surprise many Christians to know that nowhere in Scripture does it say a woman is to change her last name when she gets married. There's no scriptural command anywhere that I know of where it says that a woman's last name is to be changed. One of the things that we learn from the traditions of the Old Testament is that when people got married, their families got married. There was actually an exchange of a dowry. There was actually exchange of money. It was a legal transaction. But nowhere in those ceremonies do I see anything that says that a woman must change her last name. But that doesn't mean it is the right thing or the wrong thing to change your last name. What it does mean is that we need to get behind the question and ask ourselves, why is this woman asking that question? What is driving her to answer that question? Because one of the things that the Bible does tell us is that when we do get married, although we don't lose our individuality, there is a sense in which the two become one. When Jesus was confronted on the question of marriage and divorce by the Pharisees, they raised a question that was designed to trap him. On the one hand, if he answered the question one way, he would offend half the group. And if he answered it another way, he would have offended the other half of the group. The question was, can a man divorce his wife for any cause? And there were two schools of thought on that. One school of thought said, if you burned a dinner, he could divorce you. The other school of thought said there's no reason for divorce except adultery. And so the two schools of thought fought against each other, so they brought Jesus into the mix. And he goes on to answer the question by referring all the way back to Moses, and then before Moses, actually to creation. He goes back to Moses and he says Moses permitted a bill of divorcement over the grounds of adultery. But then he transcends that and goes all the way back to Genesis chapter 2, where we read in Genesis 2, he says, therefore a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. And the man and his wife were both naked and were not ashamed. This is all the way back to creation. It goes all the way back to Adam and Eve. And he gives us that the purpose of marriage is for the two to become one. Now, if the question is designed to raise doubt as to whether or not the two should become one, that is, if this woman is raising this question because she wants to maintain her individuality apart from her husband, then she's missing the point of the two shall become one. There is a sense in which, yes, we are to maintain our individuality. In fact, we are to celebrate our individuality. My wife is not to become a clone of me, and I am not to become a clone of her. We are to maintain our individuality, but in driving the marriage, in working the marriage out, in the way in which we have children, the way in which we make decisions, the way in which we operate our ministries, we are to be two people who become one in purpose and reflect in that oneness the relationship that Christ has with his church. Because you see, when we go to the book of Ephesians, it tells us just that, that the purpose of marriage, one purpose of marriage, is to reflect the dynamic of the relationship of Christ to his church. So we call ourselves Christians. We name ourselves after Christ. So in that sense, we are taking his last name. We are taking his full name when we marry each other. And it says that the man and the woman coming together are to reflect that dynamic. So although that gives us a hint as to whether or not we should keep our last name when we marry, it does not answer fully the question of whether or not the Bible commands it. So I would go behind this question and I would ask this person, why is it so important to you to keep your last name? Why is it so important to you to maintain your maiden name and not in your name reflect the fact that you and your husband have become one flesh? And so that to me is the broader question that you need to answer. I hope this helps.